Good evening, everyone. Just before we start tonight's show, we've got a very special and very nostalgic performance from some of our Year 13s who are going to play us in. Take it away.
This is a cromhorn. It's a medieval instrument, and my granddad made it from a kit.
Apologies for that. That wasn't quite the performance we were hoping for. Instead, here's Georgia and Ava.
Thank you. everyone, and welcome to Artsdinner, the movie. We really hope that you enjoy what we've put together for you this evening. There'll be some performances from our school choir group, speeches from our heads of department, and of course, the Boscars. There's been a programme emailed out to all of you, so you can follow along if you would like to this evening. If you haven't received this, do drop Jenny an email and she'll get one sent to you.
We've had another fantastic year in the arts, and the early cut-off didn't deprive us of the opportunity to see Miss Anderson's eccentric genius in An Enemy of the People, or Mr. Marr's discreet professionalism when wiping up the coffee he spilt with carol service programmes in the middle of a service. Let's hope everyone can hold their drinks a bit better tonight. It's been great fun being arts prefects this year, and although we're not able to celebrate in our traditional way, we hope this evening will be just as entertaining.
Of course, none of this would have happened without the tireless effort from Jenny, who has been spending her weeks mixing, video editing and putting this all together. We would also like to say a massive thanks to the Arts Department team who have allowed us to go ahead with this evening and all of their help with it. And finally, to everyone who has done hundreds of takes to put together a virtual performance.
If you're happy to be featured in the newsletter, please do send in photos of yourself celebrating to Jenny. And to help you get changed this evening, we've made some quick guidelines on what not to wear. So make sure to fix your hair, straighten your ties, grab some orange squash, and enjoy the first, and hopefully last, virtual arts dinner.
Me damn sure the pilot washed his hands and sealed his face. Pleased to meet you, hope you guess my name. But what's puzzling you is the nature. Time for a change. Killed the Tsar and his ministers. Anastasia screamed in vain. I rode a tank, held a generous rank. When the blitzkrieg raged and the bodies stank. Pleased to meet you. Hope you guess my name. Oh yeah.
Highlight for my year has to be the Strictly Come Dancing final. Since I started the scheme of work many moons ago, I never thought I'd actually be asked to be a judge. So it's been fantastic. It was so much fun, and I really loved it.
Gave ourselves the bends to an I'll never end. This year has been an extremely busy year for dance at Borlase. Despite being cut short, we still managed a few projects and performances along the way. At the end of the last summer term, we had our annual Year 7 project, this year called Humanité. The theme was a celebration of humanity across the different continents. We were given the gift of 4 beautifully written original poems by Miss Holmes that the Year 12 students were able to use as stimulus to create contemporary dance. The culmination was a beautiful piece with Year 7, Year 12 and the poems read live. This is an amazing opportunity for the Year 12 dancers to create interesting and beautiful contemporary dance through an original stimulus. We were very, very proud of all of the performers, and I would like to say a massive thank you to Miss Holmes for taking the time to write the poems for us.
On to September, and our dance clubs took off with a bang. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank all of our dance leaders who do an amazing job of running the clubs every single week. This year, our dance leaders were Imogen Bagley, Harry Fayers, Amy Kroll, Rosie Lewis, Jodie Brown, Emily Annis, Josh Leach, Alex Elliott, Jardine Barrington-Cook, Miss Yazdi and Tim Woodford. Loads. We know you've been working so hard on your pieces for the show, and we're really grateful for the support that you've given us this year.
At the end of September, we saw the newly formed Evolve 2019 to 2020 start rehearsals. They started rehearsing a piece that got longer and longer and longer as the weeks went on. Creating this piece with these dancers was a pleasure and a joy. With a slightly bigger than normal company and packed full of talent, creativity and enthusiasm, I hope that one day this piece that we created together will make it to the Borlase stage.
Throughout the autumn, years 11 and 13 were working hard on their exam work. Year 11 had their practical exam for their duo trios in December and presented some outstanding work. Thank you to Harry and Lizzie, who performed their breathtaking duo in assemblies to the rest of the school.
In December, we also said a sad farewell for now, not forever, to Mr. Galbraith. Mr. Adam Galbraith had been working with us for the last year in dance covering Mrs. Hindley. I know the students would like to say a huge thank you to Adam for all of his support and all of the hard work he put into developing their technical ability and polishing their choreographies. So thank you to Adam from all of us.
January, new year. Okay, so we had our annual production of Strictly Come Dancing. As always, this is a dazzling event, and I'd like to say a big thank you to the judges, myself, and the presenters for making the evening so special. A particular highlight was, of course, the performance from our Latin and Ballroom Club. The group have gone from strength to strength under the guidance of Harry and Imogen. Their routines are so well choreographed and polished, and we cannot wait to see what you're going to do next. A huge thank you to you both and for all the dancers for working so hard. And on to my favourite month, the month of my birthday, but better still, we call it Mad March in the dance department. And we all know it was unfortunately cut short. Before we finished school on the 20th of March, both the A-level and GCSE dance classes filmed their practical work. We're extremely proud of every single one of them to get to that point and work so hard for producing beautiful work. A big thank you must go out to all the dancers that performed in the Year 13 choreographies. I know they pushed you really hard. Thank you. Thank you from all of us for your hard work and creativity.
Not only did January bring Strictly, but with it, it brought back our very own Shirley Ballas, Mrs. Hindley. We were all delighted to see her back in the studio making us all look rubbish. And I know that students have learned a huge amount from her already, and we would like to say a big, huge welcome back. Mrs. Hindley and I miss the hustle and bustle of our studio enormously. We miss our classes, and we even miss the tears and dramas, which is something I never thought I'd say. Our dance family is made up of some very special and talented young people, and we cannot wait to get back to hard work. Year 11, you have been the most incredible class, from leaving me nice messages on my window to making me do your warm-ups at ABBA. It has been endless fun. Year 13, you have grown into beautiful performers and intelligent choreographers. We will cherish the memories we shared over the last 2 years, and thank you for making our job so fun. For now, we must present some dance awards.
Pleasure tonight to present the first award. So, the nominees for the Best Ensemble Dancer Female are Imogen Bagley, Jodie Brown, Megan Powell, Elizabeth Rackstraw, Amelia Scott, and Lucy Pryor. And the winner is Jodie Brown! Congratulations!
I'd like to take this opportunity to introduce to you our former Old Borlasians president, Greg Lynn. The Old Borlasians Club are made up of previous members of the school, all Old Borlasians or Old Borlasian members of staff, and every year they pay for the Bosker Awards in order for us to be able to celebrate the arts together and give you the Bosker statues. So I'd like to thank Greg and all the Old Borlasians Club for this and hand over to him to speak briefly to you. And hopefully when you leave school, you'll become members of the Old Borlasians Club too.
Hello. My name is Greg, and I was at Borlase from 1997 to 2003, and I am delighted to be speaking to you this evening on behalf of the Old Borlasian Club Committee. The Old Borlasian Club is very proud to be sponsoring the prizes for this evening's event. The club has two major aims: to maintain contact among former students and staff, and to promote the interests of the school. We are currently undertaking a major project to catalogue and display many of the historic artefacts and photographs in the school's archive, and we hope that our new gallery in the cloisters will be open for viewing in the coming year. As I said, the Old Borlasian Club is committed to supporting the school, and what better way than by celebrating the achievements of current students in the performing arts. The arts are incredibly important and have been a source of joy and entertainment to many of those in isolation during recent months. Whether it be theatre, opera, dance or music, these performances enrich our lives and sense of well-being. Ironically, the performing arts sector is likely to be one of those hardest hit by the pandemic, and so supporting the arts is more necessary now than ever. This is one of the many reasons why the Old Borlasian Club is pleased to sponsor the Awards for the Arts Dinner again this year. All of the club's income comes from membership subscriptions. For those of you who are leaving Borlase this year and would like to become a member of the Old Borlasian Club as a way to stay in touch with friends and to support future generations of Borlasians, you can sign up for £15 for the year via the Parent Pay website, and all members get a badge like the one I'm wearing now. For an additional £12, you can also order a club tie as part of the subscription. But to the important business of the evening. The nominees for Best Ensemble Dancer Male are Jardine Barrington Cook, Alex Elliott, Joshua Leach, and Tim Woodford. And the winner is Joshua Leach. Many congratulations, Joshua. And on behalf of the Old Borlasian Club, I wish everyone a very enjoyable evening.
Hello everyone, I hope we are all enjoying this very special arts dinner. I have been invited here to announce the nominees and winner of Best Dance Performer. Now, my last arts dinner was technically the previous year, however, as the wise Elton John said, I'm still standing. Yeah. And with that, on to the nominees. So, the nominees for Best Dance Performer are Imogen Bagley, Harry Fayers, Maddie Hill, and Lizzie Rackstraw. And now the winner of Best Dance Performer is Maddie Hill. Well done everyone for being nominated, and congratulations to Maddie Hill for winning Best Dance Performer. That is all from me. I hope you all enjoy the rest of your evening. Thank you.
Good evening. I've been asked to present the award for the Best Female Dancer. So, the nominations for the Best Female Dancer are Ophelia Almeida, Emily Annis, Jodie Brown, Amy Kroll, Maddie Hill, and Rosie Lewis. And the winner is Amy Kroll. Congratulations, Amy. Well done. Hi, everyone.
Good evening. The nominees for Best Male Dancer are Harry Fayers, Josh Leach, Tom McCrory, and Tim Woodford. And the winner is Harry Fayers. Enjoy your evening.
And the nominations for Best Choreographer are Emily Annis, Imogen Bagley, Harry Fayers, Rosie Lewis, and Lily Meyer. And the winner is Rosie Lewis. There's been some really amazing highlights with all of my classes. Probably the standout one for me this year would have to be Year 11, who basically forged a campaign to make me allow them to do a dance to burlesque in the dance show. And this went on and on and on because they played the music every time I came into the studio. They tried to show me YouTube clips. They did everything they could to try and make me love burlesque, which didn't really work. So I said to them, if you can create a dance and show me a dance, then I'll have a look and see what I think. And they created this amazing dance in an hour, which those of you that have worked with me know that I take a really long time to choreograph stuff. So that was quite incredible. Under the expert direction of Leah Graham and Emily Annis, they managed to pull this group piece together in an hour. And so how could I say no? And so I was absolutely gutted that they didn't get the opportunity to perform it in the dance show, because obviously the dance show didn't happen this year. But performance pending, we will see this dance in all its glory very soon.
La 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 So I think there's two highlights that I have for the entire year, which was very hard to choose because we do so much. But the first one was Enemy of the People, where I had to call a separate session for the stage crew in order to rehearse, as I termed it, the ballet of moving the wall structures for each scene. I think we spent a good sort of half an hour to an hour just moving these walls around to get it right, which was easier said than done. And my other highlight was just before we locked down. It was coming up to the A-level drama exams, and we suddenly needed to get all the stuff together for the set. And I realised I had no plaster bandage, and I thought, oh, we're not going to get a delivery in time, who knows? So I had to rush down to Hobbycraft and buy them out of plaster bandage, and just feeling guilty the whole time because it just looked like I was just panic buying for lockdown, but that was not it at all. And it all turned into a very beautiful set, which was designed by Lucy Plummer. So those are my highlights.
Busy 12 months in technical theatre as usual. Our Year 13 students spent countless hours putting together our rebranded outdoor music event, Summer Soundwaves. And they didn't stop there. They seemed intent on rebranding all of our events as Rocktober became Forever Autumn, a chilled acoustic event that out of necessity ended up being in the theatre rather than our usual Borlase Cabin Club. It was a lovely autumn-themed evening with plenty of fantastic music and many mini pumpkins. We never seemed to stop in technical theatre, and we were soon into production for our senior play, An Enemy of the People. The set for An Enemy of the People is Mark's most ambitious set yet, and in true Mark fashion, was larger than he imagined it. However, on the upside, this meant that for once there was no lugging staging up and down the stairs, as Mark made everything in the theatre ahead of time. What it did mean, though, is that the students had to rehearse for a long time to get the moving of the walls just right. The technical crew was brilliantly led by Lucy Plummer as the deputy stage manager and Lola Castle as the deputy production manager. Pat Hayes created a wonderful sound design for us, and Charles Washbourne was our lighting designer, who made sure the set was lit to perfection. Stage side, Jannie wrangled the tech crew with the New Year 12s, and Megan Leora looked after the many, many props, which I can only assume Miss Anderson took some inspiration from Miss Mountfield in creating a very proppy show indeed. Everyone in our tech crew, junior or senior, has played a vital part in putting together our performances this year, both curricular and extracurricular. Without an army of shifters and lifters, riggers, painters, and all of the technical expertise, the shows at Borlase simply wouldn't happen. This year we have three students moving on to higher education where they'll be studying technical theatre, which is a testament to the way that we professionally run our shows, but also the enthusiasm of our students. I have missed our weekly tech theatre lessons, and for those of you who will not be returning, I wish you the very best in your future plans, whatever they may be. For the rest of you, I'll see you soon. So stay safe and be alert.
Thank you so much, Jenny. All of our tech theatre students have been amazing over the last year, and especially our year 13s who are sadly leaving. They have been an incredible bunch from the first lesson in year 12, from independently managing events like Robot Wars and other small school events, to working so hard to realise the creative vision of our huge senior productions of Sweeney and Enemy. It's been tough for us all to move our practical subjects out of our studios and theatres to the bedrooms and kitchens. If there's one thing that this worldwide pandemic has shown us, is the need for the creative arts to keep us all sane. If it wasn't for the creative arts, we would not have Netflix, we would not have our Apple Music, our Spotify to keep us entertained. I feel blessed as a teacher to have such amazing students to teach, but also ex-students who have become good friends. I was so excited that ex-students Kat Carter and Alex Firth could help liven up my online teaching by running masterclasses online last month. Their insights into lighting the new version of Les Mis in the West End and how automation in stage design has changed the West End, I hope will inspire our production students of the future. In the past years, we have always had one or two students that decide production arts will be their career. And this year, three of our students applied, with Lola getting into her first choice drama school of Lipa, Lucy having the wonderful choice of choosing between studying at Guildhall School of Music and Drama or RADA. And finally, Patrick, who has just heard his place in sound production at Lipa, is now secure. I couldn't be happier for you all. And I hope you will be back soon to share your knowledge and with the future Borlase and Jam Tech Theatre students. But it's always lovely to see how all of our students, whatever subjects they're going on to university to study, when they leave, that they use their newfound skills from our courses and passions in production to continue with their talents at their universities across the country that they will be joining in September. Thank you, students, for working so hard this year. Thank you, teachers, for giving us such wonderful shows, concerts and events for our students to technically support. And most importantly, I mustn't go without thanking the wonderful Jenny for keeping me sane and making sure everything we do can actually happen. Now, on with the awards.
The nominations for Best Makeup are Katerina Silver, Amy Harris, Sophie Bowen Evans, and Kate Patterson. And the winner is Amy Harris.
And the nominations for Best Front of House are Toby Broyhill Fogg, Jack Donahue, Ben Ford, Bethan Norris, Lucy Plummer, Sean Ram, and Will Tucker. The BOSCA for Best Front of House goes to someone who's been leading front of house and running theatre events here since he was in year 7. I don't know what colour his hair is this evening while he's sitting at home watching us, but the BOSCA for Best Front of House goes to Ben Ford.
The nominees for Best Technical Support are Lola Castle, Lottie McBlade, Toby Broyhill Fogg, Gabe Smith, and Will Tucker. And the winner is Toby Broyhill Fogg.
The nominees for Best Technical Design and Operation are Max Brazier and Kit Kula, Charlotte Farmer, Pat Hayes, Charles Washburn. And the winner is Pat Hayes.
It is my pleasure tonight to present the award for Best Technical Leadership. The nominees for Best Technical Leadership are Lola Castle, Ben Ford, Lucy Plummer, and Gianni Scavetta. And the winner is Lucy Plummer! Woo! Congratulations!
Congrats to the winners and nominees. Anyway, up next, we've got a song about, you know, reflection, sadness, not being loved, not fitting in. It's actually Madrigal's up next. Take it away, boys.
When somebody loved me, everything was beautiful. Every hour we spend together lives within my heart.
And when she was sad, I was there to dry her tears And when she was happy, so was I. When she loved me, through the summer and the fall, we had each other, that was all.
Just she and I together, like it was meant to be.
And when she was lonely, I was there to comfort her, and I knew that she loved me.
So the years went by, I stayed the same, but she began to drift away. I was left alone,
still I waited for the day when she'd say, I will always love you. Lonely and forgotten, never thought she'd look my way. And she smiled at me and held me just like she used to do. Like she loved me. When she loved me,
when somebody loved me, everything was beautiful. Every hour we spent together lives within my heart. When she loved me.
Good evening, everyone from the Muse Department. We hope you're having a great time. We'd like to start by thanking the Arts and Front of House Captains and Jenny for organising tonight. A brilliant opportunity for us to come together and rightly celebrate what's gone on in the arts this year. We don't wish to spend time now going through everything that's happened within music this year. We know you will each have your own highlights and memories. But before we get on with the awards, we would like to thank and congratulate everyone, staff and students, who have been involved in music, in whatever form. I really do feel that, although the year has not necessarily finished in the way we might want or expect, it has been a very successful one nonetheless, with such a large range of repertoire on display and performed at a very high standard.
Hello, it's so good to be with you this evening to celebrate all the great things that have gone on in Borlase Performing Arts this year. Some particular highlights we wanted to pick out. The year started in music in full throttle with a special Borlase Choirs and Ascot Brass joint concert. A great opportunity so early on in the year for a wider audience in the Borlase community to hear a combined total of 11 pieces from Saint-Saëns to Aretha Franklin. Gosh, that feels a really long time ago now. Then there was House Music in November, in which, if I remember rightly, Saxons won the House Chapel Choir competition. and the Whole House Song Competition. Some great effort from everybody all over the school, all culminating in a fantastic final with some really inspirational performances across the age groups. Mr. Robson's Advent concert led us then to the mass choirs at Christmas, always a treat, and this year one of my favourites. And also our jazz night in February, the theatre was transformed into the West Street Lounge, and a real showcase there for Mr. Daly and the senior jazz band and the junior jazz band, and solos and small groups of jazz musicians, both current and alumni, playing to a packed house. Another great evening of music making at Borlase.
In the few weeks before lockdown began, it was some of our student-led groups that took the lead in representing the music department, with barbershop, gospel choir and chapel choir all undertaking fantastic performances in school or around the local area. And on that note, we would like to thank all of the student leaders of both choirs and instrumental ensembles for your energy and commitment in running your groups. We hope you've enjoyed doing this. Finally, my thanks must go to all the staff who have been involved and worked so hard in directing groups. So thanks to Mr. Van Ryn, Mrs. Asbeck, Mrs. Ross, Mr. Redgar-Siler, Mr. Davy and Dr. Parsons. We are, of course, very sorry that we are not able to undertake the final events of the year. Our Borlase Music at Home events, however, have shown that lockdown won't stop us making music and coming together as a community. And we look forward to restarting our busy extracurricular programme as soon as possible, whenever that day will be. So, on with the awards, and we start with the Classical Instrumentalists.
And the nominations for Best Brass Player are Reuben Bignall, Cormac Diamond, Luke Haldane and Tommy Kershaw. And the winner is Tommy Kershaw. Well done, Tommy.
On behalf of the Performing Arts team, I'd like to say a massive thank you to the Parents Association for your continued support of performing arts events. Whether in the form of providing refreshments or new equipment, we are always so grateful for the hard work and time you give us. So thank you. Now on to Mr. Hill and the award for Best Woodwind Player.
I'm here tonight to present the award for Best Woodwind Player. But before I do that, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the Performing Arts Department for welcoming me into the heart of the team. As many of you will know, I'm leaving Borlase at the end of the year, and one of the most enjoyable parts about being at the school has been the ability to play in the sax ensemble, the concert band, the jazz band, and performing some of the musicals as well behind the scenes. So thank you to Mr. Marle and the rest of the team for allowing me to do that. The nominees for the Best Woodwind Player Award are Johnny Ainscoe, Lucy Barnes, Fergus Cooper, Stevie Cooper, Charlotte Farmer, Evie Harper, Josh Cowshall, and Florence Ridley. And the winner is a well-deserving Johnny Ainscoe. Congratulations.
So no guesses for which award I'm here to present this evening. I'm here to present the award for the Best Strings Player. And it has been my privilege and my pleasure over the past years to be able to play alongside many of you, not just in school events, but also in the Marlow Community Choir and Orchestra events. So without further ado, I'd just like to tell you who are our nominees this evening. Here are our nominees for the Best Strings Player. They are Raphael Conte, Emily Farmer, Ollie Gale, Callum Conchure, Fergal Marsh, Kate Patterson, and Hector Walker. And the winner is Raphael Conte. Congratulations.
Good evening. Well, it really is a pleasure for me to be here at my first presentation at the Borlase Arts Awards. I'm glad the hairdressers are back open so I could top up my highlights before the show, which has been great. Now, for this award, Best Jazz Musician, we're not only looking for the quality of jazz performance, but also the commitment and the development of those jazz skills throughout the year. Now, the nominees are Johnny Ainscoe, Stevie Cooper, Cormac Diamond, Ollie Gale, Matt Garsk, Josh Corshall, Leon Tash, and Danny Taverner. And the winner is Matt Garsk. Would you come up, please? Congratulations, Matt. Well done.
The nominees for Best Contemporary Musician are Charles Betts, Joe Parkinson, Akash Pipian, Gabe Smith, Leon Tash, Hector Walker, and Jack Yates. And the winner is Gabe Smith.
If I had to choose just one thing that I'll take away from this year, it would actually be an academic highlight, and it took place on the first or second day of the Borlase at Home system. And it was my first Google Meet lesson with my Year 11K music class. Because unbeknown to me, what they had planned, I think the ringleader was Joe Parkinson, if I remember correctly, they had planned to all be in full school uniform. So there I was at my desk, ready for the Google Meet lesson to start, and suddenly, one by one, they appear on the screen in full school uniform, stood up with bags on their back as well. And I thought to myself, have I missed something? I think the best moment, particularly, was when Anthony Adamson turned up in a full dinner jacket with bow tie. So there they were, stood up. I let them sit down, at which point they got their bags off and unpacked it, like in a lesson, pencil case and books and everything. And I think at that moment, it was about, as I said, 2 or 3 days after we had left the way of working that we were all used to, and in this very new, strange environment. And it was just such a wonderful way to start, and it really did put a smile on my face. So that's probably for me my highlight of the year.
Thank you.
Before we move on to the Best Chorister and Vocalist Awards, I just wanted to clarify how we choose our nominees and eventual winners for these categories. Quality of performance is, of course, a factor in both. However, for the Chorister Awards, we're looking more at ensemble work and commitment. For the Vocalist Awards, we look more at those who have undertaken solo work. To present the award for Best Male Chorister, I'd like to welcome the Governor for Performing Arts, Alex Brown, and would like to thank her very much for joining us this evening. Thank you also to all the governors for their continued support of performing arts.
The nominees for Best Male Chorister are Raphael Conti, Fergus Cooper, Mark Darcy, Cormac Diamond, Charlie Evans, Callum Cuncher, Luke Haldane, Freddie McGregor, and Fergal Marsh. And the winners are Fergus Cooper and Callum Cuncher.
And the nominations for Best Female Chorister are Lucy Banks, Megan Ellis, Charlotte Farmer, Emily Farmer, Izzy Jones, Beatrice Lofthouse, Georgia Mill, Georgia Tuke, and Eleanor Vokins. The award for Best Female Chorister goes to none other than the beautiful Babette, Lucy Banks.
Good evening. The nominees for Best Male Vocalist are Raphael Conte, Fergus Cooper, Mark Darcy, Cormac Diamond, Charlie Evans, Kian Hamid, and Callum Cuncher. And the winner is Cormac Diamond.
The nominees for Best Female Vocalist are Lucy Banks, Cassie Halpin, Amy Harris, Isabel Jones, Poppy Murray, Ava Sherwood Rogers, Georgia Tuke, Ellie Vokins. And the winner is Georgia Tuke. Congratulations.
And the nominees for Best Musical Director are Johnny Ainscoe, Lucy Barnes, Raph Conti, Cormac Diamond, Charlotte Farmer, Florence Ridley, Ava Sherwood Rogers and Georgia Tuke, Gabe Smith. And the winner is Ava Sherwood Rogers and Georgia Tuke.
So, the nominations for the Best Student-Led Ensemble are Barbershop, Chapel Choir, Gospel Choir, Quintet, Saxophone Ensemble, and String Quartet. And the winner is Barbershop.
Now to transition us from the Music Awards to the Drama Awards, we have the always theatrical Borlase Barbershop. We'll be singing one of the first songs we ever sang together back in Year 9. This is My Everline.
My Everline,
my Everline,
say you.
Whisper to me, honey, you'll be mine. Way down yonder in the old cornfield,
for you,
Alpine, sweeter than the honey. Say
honey, you'll be mine. Way down yonder in the old cornfield, for you, Alpine. Sweeter than the honey to the honeybee, I love you, say you love me. Meet me in the shade of the old apple tree. My driver, oh, re-driver, oh, re-driver, oh, re-driver ever.
Love.
Favourite memory, probably an Enemy of the People memes, which were absolute genius and hilarious as well. I think my favourite one was where I said, nobody disrespects Chizza. And it's true. Wonderful arts dinner at home, celebrating the performing arts at Borlase this year. I'll try to keep this short, but you know me, I love a monologue. Here we go. It's been another exciting year for drama and our department, and we're always very proud, first of all, of the high quality curriculum work that's been produced throughout the year. The year 11s and year 13s have especially produced some outstanding work, performers and designers alike. And I'd like to say a big thank you to Miss Rayner, who had 2 year 11 classes this year and did a fantastic job in mentoring those students. The range of extracurricular work has been fantastic this year in drama. We kicked things off, of course, with the senior production of An Enemy of the People in the autumn term. It was lovely to see so many of you working so hard at this, and it all came together in the end so successfully. There were some fantastic performances, and the tech was excellent, and the doors got there in the end, and they were superb. I can honestly say that I really thoroughly enjoyed working on this production with all of you. I hope you did too, and you really deserved all the positive feedback that you got from the audiences, so well done. Another highlight was the Year 10 and 11 extracurricular project, which was new this year, where a group explored the text Living with Lady Macbeth. The aim was to perform this piece at the Maidenhead Drama Festival. Unfortunately, the group weren't able to perform because of the closures this year, but they were very, very positive about the experiences they had. And I want to thank Hannah Jolly, Charlotte Farmer and Harvey Green, who assisted with directorial and technical support as well. And a big thank you as well to Mrs. Davey, back at Borlase with us. And thank you to her for leading on this project with the Year 10s and 11s, and also for bringing Lambda back to Borlase, Lambda Sessions, which have been really successful and really popular. A farewell to the Year 13s this year, who I've really enjoyed teaching. I feel like I've taught them since they were about this high. Well, not quite that short, I don't think, but since they were young anyway, and they were the first GCSE class that I taught when I joined at Borlase. So it's very strange to be saying goodbye to you, but good luck and all the very best for the future. Finally, thank you to everybody that supported drama this year, the performing arts staff and other support and teaching staff as well, and especially Mr. Hartley and Ms. Chislett and Ms. Yazdi for all her work on the production as well. And now we're going to have a little monologue from Antigone. Only kidding. Handing over to Miss Rayner.
2019 to 2020, and what a year it has been. And considering we haven't really finished the year like we intended, I think the drama department and the performing arts department have really packed a lot in. This year, drama club wise, we have had year 7 drama club, 8 and 9 drama club all running simultaneously. And that's with great thanks to our student leaders, Poppy Morgan, Lizzie Rackstraw, for your work with year 8. You've taken them from year 7 all the way through to year 8, which shows great commitment, dedication and inspiration to those students. And Hannah Jolly started the year 9 drama club this year, again bringing wisdom and knowledge and passing it down and inspiring the younger students. So thank you girls very much. 3 years ago, I started Borlase and I was lucky enough to have 2 GCSE classes. We've had 54 GCSE students go through the last 3 years and you have been so fun to work with. I'm so, so proud of all the work you've done. We've had comedic pieces such as Bouncers and Shakers. We've had more thought-provoking pieces such as Adult Child, Dead Child. I wish you all the best in your future. And very quickly, goodbye, well done, you are amazing, to the Year 13 drama students. It's been such a pleasure to work with you throughout all the hard times, the challenging times, the fun times, the cups of tea. I wish you all the best, good luck, goodbye, and congratulations. Enjoy the rest of your evening.
Good evening, everyone. I'm delighted to be a part of tonight's virtual arts dinner and to be announcing the award for the Best Company Actor. The nominees for the Best Company Actor are as follows. Joshua Leach, Freddie McGregor, Adam Town, and Szymek Walkowski. And the winner is Freddie McGregor. Well done, Freddie, and I hope you all continue to enjoy a lovely evening.
The nominees for Best Company Actress are Neymar Bowen, Maddie Hill, Jess Leonard, Rosie White, and Zuzu Zaldua. And the winners are Neymar Bowen and Zuzu Zaldua. Well done.
And the nominations for Best Actor are Toby Broyhill-Fogg, Fergus Cooper, Mark Darcy, Cormac Diamond, Tom McCrory, and Liam Tash. And the award for Best Actor goes to someone who infuriated us as the mayor in Enemy of the People, who chilled our blood as Sweeney Todd, and who wowed us when he was just in year 9 in Beauty and the Beast, playing Gaston. Wow, what a guy. The best actor goes to Cormac Diamond.
And the nominees for Best Actress are Isabel Jones, Beatrice Lofthouse, Katie Newton, and Grace Venus. And the winner is Beatrice Lofthouse. Congratulations.
And the nominees for Best Drama Leadership are Maddie Hill and Rosie White, Hannah Jolly, Poppy Morgan and Lizzie Rackstraw. And the winner is, drum roll, Hannah Jolly. Well done.
Hi everyone, it's Georgia.
And Ava here.
And we wanted to introduce to you our gospel item for this virtual arts dinner. This piece is by the London Community Gospel Choir, but there wasn't any sheet music for it, so I actually transcribed it. And then the girls pretty much learned it by ear.
And of course, the legendary Joe Parkinson picked it up almost immediately. We really, really couldn't have done this year without him.
We just wanted to say what a pleasure it's been to lead Gospel Choir this year. We've had so many highlights throughout the year, but our favourite's got to be the Norden Farm concert in March.
The girls and Joe worked so hard to put 5 songs together in just 7 weeks.
We're so gutted to have to say goodbye early because Monday lunches really were the highlight of our weeks and we really felt like we'd formed a big family.
We want to thank the girls so much for their amazing commitment and always bring the energy to rehearsals. I hope you guys enjoyed Gospel Choir as much as we did this year because it was really, really special.
All we need now is just a little bit of faith.
Faith.
It's been such a magnificent year. There has been so many different highlights, but a few that spring to mind are the Frida Kahlo group. I never did get that cake, did I? There was the Monsters group and getting locked out on the Sunday morning when we'd come in so early to rehearse. And I think there was a meme made about me during the senior play. But it's been such a wonderful year. You guys have been absolutely incredible, and I wish you all the best in the future.
What an utterly lovely evening. Thank you. Thank you, Cormac, Rosie, Ben, Lucy, all staff and students that have been involved. And of course, a massive thank you to the inimitable one and only Jenny Chislett for putting this all together for us and doing so much over these last weeks for the arts. You've brought the best of Borlase into our living rooms, into our gardens, where we've been able to share together all the wonderful moments across the year. In fact, there's been one advantage actually about having this evening at home. I've not had to glower across the stage at all or across the theatre at all at 12s or 13s who might have sneaked alcohol into the theatre. I don't know what you're doing at home, what you may be drinking. I don't know what the staff may be drinking, but I just hope you've had a really lovely time. It's been one of my greatest privileges over the years at Borlase to be surrounded by wonderful talent across the performing arts. And that this last year, 18 months, it has to count as one of the richest seams of talent yet. In the arts, you've reached exceptional heights, not just because of that incredible talent and commitment. You exude genuine passion and joy through everything that you do and through your arts in particular. You've brought joy to me and you've brought joy to all of us. March 20th, 2020 was the strangest day ever. Everything moved so fast it was impossible to process everything really. But you were brilliant, everybody was brilliant. From the Year 7 students who'd not even been with us two terms to Georgia and Callum, leading the school and putting together actually the quickest ever brought out of the bag leavers assembly that you could imagine in order to raise the spirits of their year group and keep them together. But one of the saddest realisations I had as I crossed the cloisters on that last day was seeing the Year 13 leavers gathering together and thinking that that class of 2020 might have sung their last song for us here at Borlase. Voices I've enjoyed over the years through choirs, through small ensembles, solos and through musical theatre. But that hasn't happened. You've carried on singing, even in lockdown, using whatever technology that you can to communicate with us and to communicate with others. And I know that when we finally do get out of this current situation, we'll be able to sing together on the tops of our voices again. We'll be able to dance together in hold when we're able to writhe on the floor in a seething mass of Sweeney Todd. We'll always have tonight, always. We'll be able to look back on this and remember that coronavirus, lockdown, isolation has not brought us down. It's kept us together. We've survived it. And we'll continue to survive. And I know that in the future we will be back together, all of us. We'll be back on this site to sing together at Borlase, whatever year group you're in the future. Thank you so much, everybody, for this evening. Thank you for everything. I look forward to seeing you all again soon.
As Triumph House Captain, we want to thank everyone for all their help, working to make the show the best they can be. We have seen such a wonderful group of people helping backstage to ensure that this year was an amazing time to be part of Front of House and Tech, despite a few blackouts.
As two people who have been to almost every show this year, we've truly seen the breadth of talent the school has to offer and want to say keep up the enthusiasm and hard work you've put in, so we can continue to make the arts at Borlase the best they've ever been. And if you won't be returning next year, we hope the arts will always have a special place in your heart.
We understand this isn't exactly the arts dinner we all had in mind. We hope you had a great time and have all got as much out of the arts this year as we have. Being part of the performing arts is always such a rewarding experience. We have complete faith that next year we'll be back better than ever with some great shows to look forward to.
But of course, nothing would have happened without the endless hard work and passion from all the staff and teachers in the arts department. It's thanks to them that everyone is able to perform at such a professional standard and truly excel in the things they love. We couldn't have done it without you. Make sure
you stay healthy, safe and happy.
We thank you
all for watching.
And now it's time for a little treat, a performance from the performing arts staff.
Hear that music, 5, 6, 7, 8.
can show me how to love. Maybe I'm going through a drought. You don't even have to do too much. You can turn me on with just a touch. Baby, I look around. Since it is cold and empty, no one's around to judge me. I can see clearly when you're.
Till I feel your touch.